A few moments later. One eternity later.
Hello everybody, and welcome to my newest challenge map, Factorio Tunnel Vision. So this map is going to be all about getting to Rocket Silo without any unnecessary deviation. So we're going to research only the absolute necessities for reaching Rocket Silo, and we'll skip everything else. We are going to do it in a specific order. So I installed a little mod for that, which is called Advanced Research Queue. So basically what this mod does is when you select attack, let's say fast inserter, it automatically selects all prerequisites for the tech. So you can see we need to research automation first, then electronics, and then fast inserter. If you compare this to the normal tech screen, you can see fast inserter requires automation and electronics. So this mod does that automatically for you. So the plan is, we'll just select Rocket Silo right here, which is the final tech we need to launch a rocket, and it will automatically select all prerequisite tags before that, and that's it. We are going to research these tags in this order, whatever it may be, and see if we can get to Rocket Silo. So let's first see what we have to work with. Well, the first tag you usually would research is automation, but as you can see, this mod suggests we first research steel processing, logistics science packs, advanced material processing, and only then automation. So that means we need a good 200 red science packs and 75 green science packs to be crafted by hand before we can even make assembly machines. So then I'm getting curious where logistics will be in this order. So let's just go down the list. This text looks good. Engine, fluid handling. Yes, it looks like we're going first towards the oil processing, plastics, advanced electronics, that is getting out of hand a little bit. Speed module, chemical science pack, advanced electronics 2, that's blue chips, 300 blue science packs, and still no logistics. Alright, is logistics even required for a rocket silo? Ah yeah, it is, alright. Okay, we need railway, and railway requires logistics too. So that's good, I guess. We'll have logistics, but only after two expensive blue tags. Shortly after that we'll get purple signs, that means we're probably almost done with the tech tree. We get speed module 3, productivity module 3. We get advanced oil processing after purple signs, alright. We need that for the robot frames, I guess. So we do get robotics, but we don't get construction robots or logistics robots. Only the robot frames for the science packs. You can see here utility science pack, and then the only utility science packs you need are for rocket control unit and for rocket silo itself. So now we've gone over all the techs we get, but more importantly, let's go over the techs we are not getting. We are not getting optics, no lights. We are not getting turrets, so no turrets, no gun turrets, no laser turrets, no flamethrower turrets, no turrets at all to defend the base. Stone walls we don't get, so no walls around the base. We don't get military, that means we'll be stuck with our pistol. That's all. We will only have the pistol. No machine gun, no shotgun, and of course no advanced military techs. Further down the line, no military too, so no grenades. Grenades are always a godsend to take out biter nests, but we will have to do it only with a pistol, if we can do it at all. No military is a big deal, by the way, because as soon as we get to 20% evolution and medium biters start to spawn, it's goodbye. An attack with medium biters is game over. We cannot kill them in any way. So these dark orange tags we get, they are in the queue. We are not getting these light yellow tags, and we are not getting the red tags. So no fast inserters for the entire game. No heavy armor, which means no modular armor, no power armor, nothing. Fortunately, we can craft a light armor at the start of the game. We don't get steel axe, so mining things up by hand will take twice as long. Of course, no upgrades to military, no military 2. No military science pack at all. You don't need military science packs to launch a rocket. Very interesting. So that means any of the good military techs we won't have access to. No landfill. So if there's like a single tile of water in the way, we'll have to work around it. We don't get the modular armor, we don't get all the techs to put in the modular armor. So basically, without turrets, without military, without any way to effectively attack or defend ourselves, we have to keep pollution under control. But We don't get efficiency modules which reduce pollution. And also we don't get solar panels, so we'll have to go dirty steam power all the way. That is going to be a big deal. Alright, let's see what more we don't get. So we do get railway, but we don't get automated rail transportation, which provides the train stops, so we cannot set up a train network. Theoretically, we could set up a rail and just drive a locomotive ourselves, because we also don't get cars. No cars, only running. Or maybe setting up a personal railway. I don't know if it's worth it, we'll see later in the game. No circuit network, no explosives, so that means no cliff explosives either. No tool belt, so small inventory. Slow laps, because we don't have research speed. No stack inserters. No steel power poles. Wooden power poles only. No mining productivity. All of the military techs, we can forget about it. Power armor stuff, can forget about it. Well, the rest, all of the advanced techs, no laser, no laser turrets, no substations, no uranium mining, no nuclear power, no logistics robot, no construction robots, and of course none of the endgame techs except a rocket silo. So basically the only advantage I can get in this playthrough is map selection. So I've gone through quite a few maps and I selected one which has a nice good bunch of forest near the starting area, because we're going to generate a lot of pollution, and that pollution has got to be absorbed by something, and that something better had to be forest and not the biter nest, because once biter nest starts sending attacks, even before medium biters, it already will be probably game over, because it just takes too long to kill big groups of biters with your pistol, and they just will destroy everything. And in the meantime, before they are destroyed, the next group of attackers already will be building up, so we cannot get attacked in general. But then again, the only way we have to get rid of the biter nests is also the pistol, so we'll have to see how that goes, especially with worms defending the nest. Is going to be quite a challenge, I guess. So I think I've rambled for long enough, so let's just jump into it and see how it goes. We'll be right back.
Thank you. 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 Thank you.